As you have been in prayer this morning and studying the teachings of the Ascended Masters, I have also been in prayer for these many hours for the conditions that are upon the planetary body. They are very intense and they demand our vigilance. There are great movements occurring of peoples, there are upheavals, there is economic manipulation, there is manipulation of the internal politics of nations by those who have neither loyalty to freedom or to America or to the people of light. The study of the international capitalist communist conspiracy is complex. In my address to you during this conference, which is yet to come, I'm going to try to simplify the weavings of darkness in the fabric of the body consciousness of the earth. The analysis of the interworkings of forces of good and evil in the relative plane has been brought to us by Saint Germain, by Archangel Gabriel, by El Moria, in fact, by most of the members of the Brotherhood, because the understanding of the interworking of these forces is the key to our use of the science of the spoken word and the key to the exposure of what really is happening and what is causing, whether it's gasoline or oil or revolution or boat people or any of the many problems that we must place our attention upon. I would like to read to you now an article from the Los Angeles Times of this morning, which on the surface might not communicate to everyone just the extent of manipulation that is occurring. It is typical of what has been going on for hundreds of years. As the tares sown among the wheat upon the planetary body have sought to amass power and wealth, using for an excuse any system, any revolution, any justification of violence or terror, and always supposedly for the benefit of the people, but in reality for the benefit of the few. The few, the fallen ones who are known as the watchers, whom Jesus called the tares among the wheat. Until the children of the light, who are pocketed into right and left-wing camps in politics and religion, wake up and realize that there is an adversary and have the courage to face the adversary by the living Christ within, manipulation, divide and conquer, destruction, bloodshed will continue. Saint Germain was commenting today as I went to him and poured out my heart to him, because it is such a burden for me to see innocent people suffering at the hands of the wicked and to realize that there have not yet been enough really true devotees of God to come apart and be a separate people, to live a life of selflessness and to deliver these people from the hands of the adversary. And he was showing me the lineup of these fallen ones, extremes of right and left, and that the fallen ones assume their positions in defense of communism or socialism or defense of monarchical systems or defense of capitalism. And so whatever system may be a system that can be used by the ascended masters and their representatives will always be corrupted by the seed of the wicked, who are always attempting to prove that the system is corrupt, that the system and those who embody it must be overthrown, and in the overthrowing of the people and the system, bringing in greater and greater control of the fallen ones and wresting the control from the people of God. So we are made to believe that this is a war between capitalism and communism. In fact, Saint Germain says that it is a vying of members of the false hierarchy. Members of the false hierarchy at inner planes and in outer manifestation, actually people physically in embodiment. They have made the same commitment of Antichrist against the light of the Son of God, aborning in God's children, yet their evil is so great, their pride and ambition is so great, that they don't get along with each other either. They themselves are loners, they are independent, they are rebellious, they set up this or that system, they have a warring in their factions, And their key strategy is to appear before the people with glowing personalities and glowing promises of reform. They come into a nation, if they come in through capitalism, they may instate all types of benefits to the people and say, see me, see how good I am, see I have delivered to you all of this wonderful abundance. And it is for the elevation of the personality. And then there will be the seeds of corruption sown within itself because it is part of their psychology and part of their strategy. And so that ultimately the corruption is exposed, the people become angered, and then the other personality, the other member of the false hierarchy, comes in with his alternative system and then makes all of the promises to the people that now we are going to be delivered from all of these deadly sins of the one who has come before. And no sooner is that individual come in than we see repression and again an interference with the flow of light. So here you have in Iran, someone representing capitalism, yet backed by the multinational corporations and the international bankers, and therefore exposed by the communists, and therefore rallying around a religious leader who supposedly is neither communist nor capitalist, but is of the very same vibration, wearing simply another color. And so it's the chessboard of the false hierarchy that is moving to manipulate power. And what is the goal? The destruction of life, of law and order, but that cannot be the professed goal. The underlying goal is to sap the light of the people, draw it unto themselves, perpetuate an existence which no longer has viability because they have long ago been cut off from the living fount of the Almighty. So the international power play, nation by nation, goes on. And I am not here to pass judgment, right or wrong, upon all of these international figures. I am here to expose to you their modus operandi so that you can analyze for yourselves what is happening. The net gain and the fruits of their actions is death, destruction, disruption, and no longer the alignment of the forces of freedom, but to so disrupt society that the people can no longer themselves organize and be free, be united in freedom, and overthrow their tyrants. The people of Russia are crying out for freedom. Their voices are not communicated to us except by our hearts. We are led to believe that communism is popular and that it has the majority behind it. And yet it is a slave nation of enslaved peoples. Why can they not overthrow their tyrants? Because it is an international conspiracy, because of the backing of their overlords by the international clique of these tyrants, these watchers. They feed each other, they supply each other with weapons, arms, money, and whatever is necessary for the warfare against the light bearers. So there is an international clique of fallen ones who dominate the course of events upon the planetary body, and the light bearers have not gotten so smart. They have not realized that there is a conspiracy and that they are its victims. They haven't stopped to observe that they have been divided, but they instead have gone the way of disobedience to the original mandates of the Ancient of Days, to the 12 tribes of Israel. And by their stubbornness and their rebellion, they were cast abroad, their karma returning to them as they embodied in Assyria and Babylon, and finally were dispersed. So this is the age and the hour of the reunion of these light bearers, the race of the I Am, the I Am that I Am, those who have an I Am presence and a living light within their hearts, and who have the original tie of the seed of light, often called the seed of Abraham. It is the seed of the living Christ, and it is in peoples of every nation and every race and every religious conviction. And instead of uniting as one people worldwide to overthrow these tyrants, they remain segmented into right and left political systems created by the fallen ones, led by the fallen ones and their shining personalities to keep the people divided. It's as simple as that. We were never meant to be divided politically and to have political parties be used to divide and conquer us and rally us and separate us. Our way of life is the community of the Holy Spirit. Our way of life is the community of Israel, the community of America, Every point of division is a point of weakness. There are many, many more children of light upon earth than there are these key watchers. But Saint Germain's very clear point is this, that the fallen ones will come out with their shining personalities and garments and present themselves as world saviors. They may even be world saviors through the entertainment media. And they rally millions of people in sympathetic support of their cause. Whether it's sympathy for Elvis Presley or for this or that personality, they rally people around them. They have a magnetism that is of lunar substance. It's a moon substance. And they magnetize people around them, and people will give their life for these fallen ones because they somehow present this sympathetic personality and promises of salvation, which reveals that the children of God have never overcome their propensity to idolatry. They would rather idolize a savior in politics or in the economy than raise up the living savior within themselves and take full responsibility for life and for the environment and for the nations. And this is what we are finding today. On the one hand, the fallen ones manipulating the people. On the other hand, the people forgetting the original one God, I am that I am, and remaining obedient to the moral and the ethic and the code and the honor of that living presence of God who stands where we stand. And so there is a betraying of that God, there is a whoring after other gods, and the reason we gather at Camelot here for the Freedom Conference is to become enlightened, to become filled with light, and to then go forth with the sacred word, both as a dynamic decree and as a living, vital message. We must have that message, and it must be transferred by the Holy Spirit with such power, such authority, such conviction that the people are awakened rudely and abruptly from their self-imposed hypnosis and the sleep induced upon them by the fallen ones. This is why we are here, not merely to enjoy a weekend retreat, but we are here to become filled with light, filled with an intense light that will break the spell. The world is under a spell of tyranny, a spell so long endured that people prefer that tyranny to a freedom that takes work. Hard work. It takes hard work. And those who are able to resolve that equation are the truly quickened and awakened. I would like to tell you in passing that I have prepared for you, for this conference, a message that you must learn as though you were studying your first grade McGuffey reader. You have to study it like you'd study reading, writing, and arithmetic. It's the studying of the gospel of the Aquarian age. It's the studying of Mother's Manifesto.